Greetings, friends! Me, Widdle Wade, here to show you the tutorial on cold casting that I promised. So, without further ado, here it is. First up, you're gonna need your mold. Duh, it's kind of important. And your metal powders. This time we're going with iron. You're also gonna need black pigment for your resin. It just kind of helps to hide things. And of course, resin. I got a little shakery thing, I thought it might come in handy. Of course, you're gonna need your scales for measuring things out, and most importantly, this mask thingy. You're gonna have a horrible cough if you don't use one. First of all, we're going to spoon in some of the metal powder. One. Two. Wait, a little bit less. Now, a little more. There we go. See? I'm wearing it! So we're gonna just shake in the powder. Just shake it in, run it around. Make sure you get it nice and even over the whole mold. Then when you're happy with that, there's bound to be lots of excess. So just put it back. Now, time for measuring resin. As with all my belt buckles, about 50 milliliters of resin will do the job. I know it's 49, but, you know, when you mix in the thing. Mix it all in with the pigment. Here's one I made earlier. Poured and ready to go. That's gonna take a while. Might as well go get a sandwich.
On account of the weather. What with it coming into summer and all, here in Ireland it's still freezing, so the buckle still didn't cure, even after eating. So I decided to put it in a hot press, or airing cupboard, as you Yanks like to call it.
So it finally cured, whoopee. What you're gonna need is steel wool to polish the metal. And it comes out kinda like that. Kind of came out much darker than I wanted, so I'm gonna try again with aluminium powder. Stay tuned and thanks for watching.